Here is lesson one for our DipTrace design software. It's a startup package for a real quick project. First thing you need to do is go to this DipTrace website and then download the software. I would choose the freeware, of course, and depending on your computer, do you either 32-bit or 64-bit. I would also download the libraries and 3D models. There's some cool things we'll do with that in the later. It is free, and just go ahead and download it, and then you can start. Here are the web addresses for the download and for the tutorial. Tutorial's pretty good, but I'll do a real quick crash course, and you can use it for a reference later. So when you want to open it up, once you got it installed, go to D and go to DipTrace. I would use the DipTrace launcher. That gives us access to everything. Here is the DipTrace launcher, and we will start with the schematic capture. Here's a circuit we're going to build. It's an LED flip-flop circuit based on transistors. I built it in multi-sim so I can show that it actually works. And what it is based on two transistors, two NPNs, and two LEDs. And what we have here is capacitors and resistors. Here we got an RC circuit, and these RC circuits are going to time and charge up and discharge and turn our transistors on. So these two transistors are going to fire in sequence, which is going to turn our LEDs on in sequence, and they're going to flash opposite. Here's a working circuit right now, and you see that the LEDs are firing back and forth simultaneously or in sequence, and we could change that by changing this RC circuit. We could change the timing of the flash. Here's a circuit as built in DipTrace, and you can see everything's there, and we'll start building it from our components in miscellaneous positions. Here's our starting position that we're going to have, and here is the toolbar. This arrow is very important. That is when we start moving things, we need to make this arrow go on. Sometimes we have to stop what we're doing and go up and re-click that arrow. Also, I think double click on the left button of your mouse will get back to this point. Here we have our project libraries. We're just using our design cache, only the parts that are used here. And we could go through our list and then take a look at this component, its symbol, and we could look at its actual footprint that's going to be on the PC board. And we could go through one by one. So we're going to start with the schematic capture, and we're going to go from there. First thing I'm going to do is do rough locations of my components that kind of match the schematic that I have in my already printed out. So I'm just going to roughly lay these out. Okay, once we have them roughly laid out, we need to put them in the right position. This transistor pointed in the wrong direction, so I'm going to right click and I am going to flip horizontal. Now I have the base in the right direction. All these, okay, so I can right click and I'm going to rotate. Okay, or I could push R key, which is faster. Just click on it and flip. Looks like our LEDs need to be flipped. Okay, now we're in the basic position we need to be. Now that we have our parts located on our paper, let's go ahead and build our circuit. First thing we need to do is I notice that we're missing a ground. So let's go find a ground. So we're going to go in through our main libraries components. That's where all the main libraries are located. And we're going to go down to net ports. Net ports is where we have our voltages and a ground. So we're going to go down and grab a ground. We're just going to click them in. Good. Now let's go back to our project layer design cache where we have everything back. Now that we have everything there now, let's go ahead and look at our different view windows. So this one is zoom window. So if I wanted to zoom in, just do that. If we want to go to extents, extents would be to the extent of our circuits, not the whole page. We could also scroll up, scroll down, or we could move our little tabs here, and we could move the schematic any way we want. So let's go back to extents. That one looks pretty good. There we go. So now we have everything. So let's put our wires in. And we have two wire types. We have one wire and we have buses. Buses for multiple wires and for interconnecting from different schematics or pages. So let's go ahead and just start. So we're going to click. And let's just keep doing that, and we'll clean up when we get all done. Click. So we're making our base connection. Collector. Okay, we have a stray here, so we're going to right click and cancel. Click. And let's just say I make a mistake. So let's go up to our arrow, boink, and we're going to click and then just push the delete button. Okay, or you can right click and then left click and delete wire. Let's go back and hook them back up. Okay, whoops, one more. So let's go ahead and use our arrow and get everything positioned. So you know you have it when it turns the light blue there, changes colors. Let's clean this up a little bit, let's move it down. There we go. Let's just move this whole line, we're gonna window it. Move it back. Good. Now we've got the wires in, but we have some problems here. Our resistors are incorrect. So this guy is going to be a 47K. That's a 470. That's correct. So let's go ahead and make this another 470. That's a resistor that's going to control the current to our LED. And this last guy is going to be 47K. Okay, let's see. Do I have my capacitors incorrect? No, I don't. So we can do a couple things here. The best thing to do is let's go ahead and let's just delete the wires. And I could switch positions or I could rotate them. Let's just switch positions. We've done rotate already. Okay, good. Here's our curved area. That's our minus side. And I've got them both correct. Good. And we have a schematic.